You're listening to Kpoppin, every day 12 to 2 p.m. The fastest K-pop news with DJ Isak.
Ugly Truth. It's time to have Sooyoon of Royal Pirates in the studio. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, good.
You said you're kind of tired.
Yeah, I'm very tired because I started again to work out. I stopped for a couple months. And now I'm,
well, you've been busy.
Yeah, and now I'm just trying to, you know, get back with working out. And my body's like super sore everywhere. Yeah, and I try to eat a lot because my body type's kind of, I lose weight really easily.
Ah.
So I have to kind of work out and eat a lot. So I've been eating a lot too.
Oh, that's a stress reliever,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah, but sometimes it's kind of hard.
Yeah, well, if you're busy.
Yeah, I have to eat a lot, but it's like kind of, I'm always like full and I don't like that feeling of like getting stuffed, you know?
Ah,
yeah.
Okay. Why am I in the complete office? Anyways, did you know that James has been taking over the show after mine for the past week?
Right.
Did you listen in?
I didn't have a chance to yet, but I heard like couple, you know.
Little bits and pieces,
yeah.
Okay.
He's telling me that he's really awkward, but I'm sure he's doing well.
Well, he says that he's getting better.
Yeah.
I haven't really been able to listen to him either, but I get to see him. So it's really good that I get to see your members and you more often now.
Yeah.
Because it's good to see you guys at work. last week, I read the message late because you and I were talking so much about our stories that Eric Nam was listening to us from Teju last week.
Oh, wow.
I totally forgot to read the message on air because I read it after the show.
Uh-huh.
So thank you, Eric Nam, for listening to us while you were on Jeju-do Island. Apparently, he was shooting a show there.
I see, he
caught us on the airwaves.
Awesome.
Anyways, we have a thank you message. Isabel says, "Isaonni and Sooyoon, thank you so much for the amazing pieces of advice that you gave me last week for the first story. It really, really helped a lot. Sorry, Sooyoon, if it kind of sort of brought up bad memories from the past. But thank you.
Thank you.
He said it first, so
we
didn't pull it out of him to tell us those stories.
Right.
Okay, so we're going to get into our ugly truth. Like usual, our first story is going to be divided into Team A or Team B. So listen to the story carefully, because not just us, but you, our listeners, are going to be giving our listeners some advice. So listen carefully.
All right. It's from Brazil.
Ooh.
From Carolina Sugimoto.
Okay.
Hey, guys. So I have a problem, a self-esteem problem. Not with my looks, but about my qualities. Recently, I started college again. I'm majoring in professional makeup. I do the makeups. People say that it looks good, and I really appreciate their praises. But deep inside, I don't think I did that great. And it's starting to disturb me, because I want to work with makeup, makeup people and make them feel great. But deep inside, I don't think they'll like it, that I'll fail. I really like to make up people. I want to be like some makeup artists, but this insecurity is starting to make me think about giving up. Give up because I'll never success in this business. What should I do? By the way, I want to let you know the Royal Pirates and Isak have fans here, so please guys, come visit us. I'll be your guide here. I'll give you a whole tour.
I want to go to Brazil! Brazil, please!
Brazil.
I want to go!
I said this like five times I love to go to Brazil.
Please!
Yeah.
Some big radio show or TV show, have like an RP Isak special.
Yeah,
and
please.
We'll go and I'll like eat the food there. I don't care what it is. Give me food!
Yeah.
I love Peruvian food. I've tried a few Brazilian dishes.
Yeah.
I just love the food there. Mm-hmm. Please.
When it's cold like this in Korea, I want to go to like, you know,
warmer countries.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Awesome.
Yeah. All right. So, Carolina, Team A is don't worry too much, trust yourself, and, you know, take in all those compliments. If you're, and B, if your confidence in your dream is not there, you might want to change your profession. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think it's so much about her passions not being there. I think that she just is trying to be too much of an overachiever, maybe.
I see.
Maybe.
I'm kind of a person who doesn't care what other people say. I only care about what I really think deep inside. So, like, when people, works with like props and like cons. When people kind of criticize me, it doesn't matter to me. As long as I think my product is good.
Okay.
But when people also says that it's good, if I don't feel like it's good, it's not good. So it doesn't matter to me.
Okay.
I think she's kind of like that.
Okay.
She doesn't take other people's praises because she thinks that it's not great. So she thinks her self-esteem's, you know, getting lower, I feel like.
Okay. In that situation, then how do you kind of increase that confidence, you personally, since you don't really try to care about what other people do say?
Yeah. I think setting my standards, where I set my standards is really important. When I was younger, I set my standards, like, I thought I set it pretty high.
Okay.
But, you know, I was very trapped in, you know, what I see.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't know enough about other people, like, and other music. So I felt like, oh, man, I'm so good.
You know?
Yeah,
okay.
Because right? I didn't see enough. And I didn't hear enough. And then I came to Korea and, you know, I see more people. And I see, like, as I grew up, I see more. And YouTube, you know, obviously let me see and hear more performers, more music, more bands. And then I feel like, I felt like, oh man, I'm not good enough, you know? Yeah, so.
It's intimidating.
Yeah, it's intimidating.
Okay.
And then, you know, trying to adapt in Korean music business also, it's a whole different world. And I'm not ready for that. I wasn't ready for it. So I felt like, and then my self-esteem just, you know, went down. But then, at one point, I was just like, you know, that doesn't matter. As long as I enjoy it, and then as long as I'm happy with what I do, I think, just the skills itself, I don't think it matters that much.
Okay.
As long as, you know, you have fun with it. And skill is eventually going to, you're just gonna get better.
Okay.
You know, if you just keep trying.
All right. So pretty much Team A.
Yeah.
Okay.
For me, Team A.
All right. For me, I'd have to go with Team A as well. And the reason is, I agree with Sooyoon. When it comes to you yourself, if you're doubting yourself, obviously, Carolina, you're going back to college. So going back to college, I know, is very difficult because I've done this myself. Doing other things, maybe changing fields, and going back to college after being an adult or being in the, quote, real world is very hard to be institutionalized. I feel, you know, like you're set to look up to people again. It's not like you're being respected as a student and you're just a student again, which is really hard. To see younger people that are better at things that you've never done or knowing new techniques that you've never done before.
Right.
I feel that especially in the makeup world, there's so many different types of makeups that you can get into. I think that Carolina, right now, yes, what your classes are trying to make you do, try to do as much of that as possible. But also in between, try and find some makeup styles or techniques that you really like.
Yeah.
For instance, there's a lot of gory dramas that are popular these days, like The Walking Dead and many more.
Yeah.
That's also makeup artists.
Yeah,
like, they're not into, I'll glam you up, red carpet type of makeup, but they are considered makeup artists.
Yeah.
They know how to make puffed up, you know, scars gorges you know, being cut.
Blood.
Blood and, you know, bruises.
Yeah.
and scarring and stuff like that. So that's also a form of makeup artistry. Sure. Also, people who are very good at body painting are literally artists that are using bodies as canvases. So you can also look into that as well.
Yeah.
Just because makeup is, you know, getting people dolled up, it can be very different. Mm-hmm. And I feel that probably Sooyoon has noticed this too. There are certain stylists and certain makeup artists that specialize in male makeup and then in female makeup. Also, there's pictorial makeup, which is like, you know, glam up, like, you know, a lot of makeup or natural look makeup. So with so many different sides to the makeup in general, I'd say in between your classes, try to find a makeup style that's perfect for you. And then maybe try to find projects that would help build your confidence with that.
Right.
So for our listeners, all you need to do is kind of help us with this first story. Team A or Team B? Should Carolina, you know, not worry herself too much, trust herself and, you know, complete what she's doing now? Or maybe the passion is not there. That's why she's doubting herself. And maybe she should start changing what she thinks of. So for all of our listeners out there, start sending in Team A or Team B. The winning team, we're going to choose one person and send them in. Hold on.
Okay.
Oh, Vivi is from Brazil. I'm Carolina's friend. She does body painting and horror makeup, and she's really good. Her horror makeup is really scary, and she loves doing it. So there you go.
That's great.
Yeah, so
Halloween.
Exactly. Past, well, not just Halloween, but, you know, if she's really good at the gory stuff, then there you go. I mean, if you found your field, the courses right now, they might stress you out because you have to do very diverse things. But still, I mean, if she's found what she's got a knack for, I think that she should just go with it.
Yeah. It might take, you know, some time, but as long as you keep doing it, and then, as you know, people are going to notice that you're good, you know, good at something. Eventually, you know, it doesn't, I think, like art, it takes time always for people to notice what you're good at. I think, yeah, I mean, there are some people, you know, like some geniuses who are like crazy good in the, from the beginning, and people are it's obviously good, but usually there's so many artists, so many people, so many musicians, so many, you know, painters or artists, makeup artists, you know, that it's gonna take some time for you to kind of pop up from that huge group of people, you know? So, just don't worry about it and just keep doing it. Don't give up.
I think baby steps. If we kind of backtrack to what Sooyoon was saying in the beginning about when he was in the States doing music and before he came to Korea, because he was taking baby steps, he was doing what he liked, what he was comfortable with, the music that he was doing. He found himself after taking baby steps, oh, I'm good at this. I'm the best in my field. But then he came to Korea and then he was in a new pool. But of course he took his baby steps and, you know, those baby steps just, you know, let's take it a day at a time, you know, a project at a time. So for our listener, Carolina, just take it, you know, a midterm or a final you know, a project at a time and then just try and do your best. And then if you look back at the semester, you'll probably realize, oh, I've grown a lot in what I've done.
And you don't realize that.
Exactly.
You know, you just realize after everything is done. And don't worry about like younger people who like who are really good at certain stuff, because honestly I used to be that person. Like when I was younger, like a lot of drummers from I went to music school MI, and a lot of older people were amazed at my skills at that time. But then it's easy to be that good, and then to be from there to get to another level is really hard.
Exactly.
And it takes a lot of time. So I became that older person now, you know? And then I see a younger kids, I'm like, wow, you know?
They're really good.
How can they do that when they're that age? But when they turn my age, they're not gonna be like super better.
You know,
it's gonna take a long time for them to become, you know, at a certain level as well.
Exactly.
So don't worry about it.
Yeah. When you think that they're better now, like he's saying, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, when they hit your age, it's going to be a lot different for them, for them to exceed what they are doing now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So we are both going for Team A, so either Team A or Team B. The winning team, one lucky winner, gets a Polaroid from Sooyoon. So keep that in mind. we're going to take a quick song break, and then we're going to come back for our second story. But Kiko and Design T and Hot Filter are on the track with 화장지였어, or No Makeup, and we'll see you guys after this.
See ya.
With that, we're back, and Carolina actually posted a picture of her makeup.
Oh, wow. Awesome.
This is awesome.
Wow.
I love your makeup, man. Dang.
That's really good.
That's really good. You're really good. Wow. So yeah, she got your inspiration from Royal Pirates. She was a bloody pirate. All right, so we're still going to help Carolina out just a little bit more, even though she's listening right now. Team A or Team B for our first story. Mm-hmm. But let's move on to our second story. It looks like it's a little bit about relationships.
Okay, it's from Bulgaria, from Asha?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Hello, beautiful DJ Isaac and handsome Sooyoon. Now, my ugly truth. I've got an older brother, 3 years apart. He's 21.
Okay.
And he's always so jealous of me. I mean, he asked me to go out with him and his friends, and then he is talking with them. And he tells them, don't touch my sister. And, you know, some that kind of sort of things. I know that it's normal for brothers to protect his sister, but not to this point. One time I was on a party of his university, and his roommate started talking with me. My brother came and said to him, don't talk with my sister. You're not suitable for her. And I was like, really? I don't know what to do with him. I love him, but that this behavior really makes me mad. Waiting for your super advices, DJ Isaac and Sooyoon. Thank you in advance.
I mean, I'm an only child, so.
Yeah, I mean, I don't have any sisters, so. But I have a cousin who's my age, and she's, you know, she's kind of pretty.
Mm.
A lot of guys, you know, hit on her.
But
then, I don't know, I feel like she's my sister, but I don't get jealous like this.
Uh-huh.
We're more of like a friend.
Mm-mm.
And I'm just like, oh, so how was that guy?
Mm.
You know? And she's like, blah, blah, blah. And like, oh, don't meet that guy, you know?
Ah.
But I'm not like, oh, don't touch her, you know?
I have an older cousin. We are 7 years apart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 7 years apart.
Yeah.
So we pretty much grew up together as brother and sister.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I have to thank him for, I think, my entire career, because 90% of the music that I listen to now, he kind of introduced me to when I was younger. So all the R&B, hip hop, and all that other stuff.
Cool.
He is really tall. Mm-hmm. But he's also very big, too. So he did wrestling in high school and in college.
Uh-huh.
And he's very, he looks like a bodyguard. Let's just put it that way.
Okay.
And he likes to, and obviously because LA does not get that cold.
Yeah.
The most that you're going to wear is probably a leather jacket for guys in the wintertime.
Right.
So he doesn't really come up and say, don't touch her.
Uh-huh.
It's just whenever he sees me, he's just like, so do you have a boyfriend? I'm just like, why? Uh-huh. He's like, you know, before you get married, I have to drink with your your significant other. I'm just like, no, you're not going to. Because my cousin can drink. He can hold his alcohol. Mm-hmm. He's like, I'm putting a bottle of tequila between us and we're going to see who wins.
Oh,
I'm just
like, tequila.
No, don't kill my, you know, significant other.
Yeah.
But he's kind of like that. But he's not like super jealous, like to this point.
Yeah.
Like if a guy's talking to me. Mm-hmm. What he likes to do is we'll walk in public. So if it's a group of us cousins, he'll walk in back of us on purpose. And then he'll watch guys like check me and my cousins out. And then, you know, if a guy checks somebody out, they'll kind of, you know, look around to see if there's a guy present.
Yeah.
Then my cousin will stare them down. He'd be like, what? What you looking at? He'd be like, what? He's done that before.
Oh, I see.
But he's never really gotten to this point
right?
where he's like, don't touch her. Yeah. Don't talk to her. If he was this overprotective, in my opinion, I wouldn't take my sibling out.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, if he's this overprotective, why take her out with, like, hanging out with his friends?
Yeah.
Shouldn't he be, like, locking her up in a tower somewhere?
I know. He shouldn't take her out to anywhere.
Exactly.
You know? Yeah. Actually, James has a younger sister.
Oh.
And I think James is a little protective, but not to this point, I think. But, I mean, he always says she's, like, my daughter, you know? So.
Oh, there's a big age gap there.
Like, 5 years, I think. Five years apart.
Okay.
Which is, you know. Not small, but not that big.
True.
Yeah, but he takes good care of her, but I've never seen James, you know.
This?
Yeah, this far. He's always like, oh, she shouldn't get a boyfriend, you know? But, you know, she got a boyfriend one time, and then James was like, oh, she got a boyfriend.
Yeah.
But he's not like, you know, break up with
exactly.
him.
Exactly.
You know?
Yeah. He's not going to be like, call and be like, you touch my sister, I kill you.
Yeah,
he's not going to be doing that.
Yeah.
Aisha, I think it's a compliment. He's 21. Give him a year of college. Give him a year of college. I think it might change.
Yeah, he's got busy, you know.
Yeah, he's gonna be too busy. Exactly.
You know?
He's gonna be way too busy with his own career.
Yeah, right.
And his
with his own career.
And his own girlfriends
school
and his own friends
and
school.
Yeah,
and
he's gonna be busy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like James is busy.
Oh.
So I think as James is getting busier, you know,
his sister's probably a lot happier now.
In some way.
In some way. I bet James is outside right now.
Yeah, right? He's probably listening
probably
to us.
Probably listening to us and be like, no.
Yeah.
No. Well, James, if you are listening outside in the studio somewhere, you can always walk up into the live show and you can, you know, state your own story if you'd like.
I mean, Moon has a younger sister. And he has a big age gap. I think like 7 or 8.
Ah.
But I don't know how he is like with his sister. Like if he's protective or not.
I don't think he's protective if you don't know. Because if he was protective, I think
you
I think he would know. Because if you, obviously with the members and all.
Yeah. I think Moon's more of a laid-back brother than James. And
I think, just by looking at those two, I think you could see that.
Yeah, right.
I feel that Moon's just be like, whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. But then, like, James's like, I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, if I had a sister, I feel like, I don't know, I don't have one, but if I had one, I'll be like, come on, like, get a boyfriend, you know? You know?
Get a life!
Yeah, because, you know...
Go away!
Yeah, like, meet some people, you know?
Get out of the house for a change. Aww.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see here. We've got a family that's really protective as well.
Mm.
Ooh, okay. Madison says, my silly uncle. My uncle did the same thing with my ex-boyfriend when we were dating.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, dear Lord.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of scary, though, when like the adults come in.
Yeah.
When the adults come in, then it's really hard for the significant others to do anything.
Yeah.
But, I mean, cousins or older brothers, it's just kind of like, yeah, you know?
Yeah.
It's not acceptable, but, you know, it's still less scary, I feel. Mm-hmm. All right, Vivi's saying, let's see, I have an older brother. Okay, she has to settle him down and say, okay, brother, I love you, but you're being silly. I know you just want to protect me, but you are actually annoying me, so please stop. Wow, Vivi, there you go.
Right.
Just confront him. Well, he's 21. Well, you're still underage. Never mind. I was like, if you're old enough, you know, buy him a drink and be like, dude, here's a girl. Yeah. Stop caring about me.
Oh, that's so cute.
Oh, okay. So, Asha, just maybe talk with him.
1 or 2 years.
Yeah, give him a year or two. Yeah. I think he's going to stop.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Second year and third year in college, I don't even think he's going to remember his name. Depending on what kind of college he went to.
Right.
With all of the, because even now, one of my cousins, she's a girl, and she's in her last year of college. Mm-hmm. First year of college, I got a lot of texts from her. Mm. Up until, I think, like last year, I got a lot of texts from her.
Yeah, yeah,
but now that she's in her final year, she's all over the place. Like, I'll get a text from her maybe like every 2 to 3 months when I used to get like a few, like a week.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's like, oh, what are you doing? Like, da, 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 da. I'm just went here. I just got back from this, da, 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 da. But I think she's now to the point where she's like, life, kill me.
Yeah.
Because,
it's hard.
Yeah, because it's her last year and what. So, yeah, I feel that, Asha, if you give him about a year or two, he'll back off naturally.
Yeah.
And if he gets a girlfriend, he might back off naturally.
Yeah. So you might want to take him out to... you know,
see your friends.
With your friends.
Exactly.
And see, then you could be protected over him.
Exactly. And make him see how it feels. You can be like, don't touch my brother. And then let him see how he feels.
Oh, I feel like that'd be kind of cute, though. I'd be like, oh, my sister loves me.
Yeah, she's trying to protect me.
But go away. So I can hang out with your friends. You know?
I feel that Sooyoon would probably do that if you had a younger sister. You'd be like, so, any cute girlfriends?
Yeah, right.
Anyways, going back to Carolina, she's listening to us today, and it looks like that she's feeling a little bit better. But still, for any other our other listeners who might be going through the same thing about self-esteem issues, what should she do? Should she still keep pushing through, even though she's lost a lot of confidence in herself, which is team A? Or team B, if you feel that the confidence is down, then maybe your passion is down as well, and maybe it's time to think of another field. So either way, team A or team B, we're going to choose one lucky winner from our winning team and send you a Polaroid from Sooyoon.
All right.
Okay. Let's see here. You're going to be singing for us today.
Yes, I am.
Yay! As soon as he walked into the studio, he's like, I don't think I can sing today.
Yeah.
But you said that last time and
raining,
you were amazing.
You know?
You said that last time and you were amazing, though.
Oh, no.
Aww. He's like, he's getting all blushed. He's like, okay, here we go.
You gotta get ready?
Yeah, get ready. Right. What song are you going to be singing for us for today?
I prepared an English song today.
Ooh!
Yeah. Last time I sang in Korean. So
yes.
This time it's Bibi Your Love from Rachel Yamagata.
Wow. Okay, show. Whenever you're ready.
Whenever I'm ready.
All right, so he's going to take a sip of water and then he's going to get ready and then we're going to get a chance to listen to Sooyoon singing.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I'm not ready for this. All right. If I could take you away, pretend I was king, what would you say? Would you think I'm unreal? Everybody's got their way, I should feel. Everybody's talking now, I can't be your love. I wanna be your love. I wanna be your love for real. Everybody's talking now, I can't be your love. I wanna be your love. I wanna be your love for real. Want to be your everything. Yeah. Everything, oh, everything's falling. And
I am included in that. Oh, how I try to be just okay. Yeah. All I ever wanted was just a little piece of you. Everybody's talking how I can't be your love. I wanna be your love. I wanna be your love for real. Everybody's talking how I can't be love. I wanna be your love. Wanna be your love for real. Want to be your everything.
So the message board is going crazy. We've got a lot of messages. Madison says, "Sooyoon singing. I love your singing voice. I'm crying right now. I hope Royal Pirates will come to Atlanta, Georgia, U.S. soon for a concert." Thank you. Oh my goodness.
Oh, I love to go to States.
Oh, yes. That would be great. Yeah. We've got Carolina, who is the star of our first story, saying, mm-hmm. "Sooyoon should sing more often, but I don't know if my heart would be able to put up with it."
Aw, sweet.
We've also got Liana from Malaysia saying, "Sooyoon's song selection suited so much for this segment." Oh, so soothing. Yay! Yes, we also love it when Sooyoon is singing in the studio.
Yeah.
Vivi says, "Sooyoon, that was so beautiful. I'm a little emotional today."
Oh, thank you.
"So I even started crying a little bit. Your singing just kept getting better and better. I'm so proud of you. That was an amazing job." We got some other messages. Oh, my goodness. This is all in caps. This is all in caps. Rayshawn from the USA. "Sooyoon, I had to stop my dishes and tell you I love your voice. Yes, I'm even commenting with all caps. Sing more, Sooyoon. Wow, I'm speechless. But then again, I have so much to say. Beautiful job."
Thank you. I mean, I usually don't like it when it rains, but I selected this song before. Before I came here.
Okay.
So, usually I don't like the rain, but today when it rained, I was like, this song is going to be good.
It's going to be a perfect song for today because it's raining. Aww. Yeah. Okay. A lot of our listeners are commenting, "I kind of feel bad that I've been dressing popcorn in all gray these days."
Oh, this is great. I didn't know you made this.
Yeah, I did.
I just found out today.
But yeah, so they're saying that you two kind of matched today.
Oh, yeah.
Because of your attire. So they're ready for the end of fall and the
introducing. Yeah, I need a big heart here.
I need a big heart here. This heart took forever. Okay, so we still have Sooyoon in the studio. Sooyoon, before we get into our second story.
Yeah.
Next month, you guys have something pretty exciting happening.
Oh, yes. We are having our first live concert in Korea.
Wow!
Just by ourselves.
Ooh!
Yay!
RP's having a concert in Korea! Yeah. Yay!
It's in December 16th at Sangsang Madang Live Hall in Hongdae.
Yes!
Yeah.
Okay.
It's our first concert by ourselves in Korea.
Yes!
Right.
It's gonna
be awesome. It's gonna be fun. It's called Thank You Party. we're just thanking everybody, our fans, you know, our family, our friends, and everybody. So you should come too.
Yay! Okay, mm-hmm. I got the invitation on air.
Right.
So if I go to the door that day and I don't get in, I'm taking a picture of it and posting it and be like, these boys invited me and they didn't let me in.
Yeah. You can break into the stage, you know, if you can't come in. You know.
Break in. Sounds good. Yeah. All right. We've got our last story from the Philippines from Ashley.
Ashley from the Philippines. Hi, DJ Isaac and Sooyoon. I'm a big fan of Royal Pirates in the Philippines. How are you?
We're good. We're great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Pretty good.
Just last night, we watched the movie with time travel concept. I had a debate with my sister about time travel right after we finished watching the movie. We talked and talked, but we can't control our feelings. So now our topic is time travel a possible or impossible thing? This question still bothers me. What's your opinion about this? This is a pretty interesting
question.
Did
you guys just watch Interstellar?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, probably. Interstellar. Probably. Or what was another recent one? Maybe About Time.
About Time.
About Time. Oh, I really enjoyed About Time.
Yeah. That was an amazing movie. Yeah. It was so underrated. That was a amazing movie. Mm. Just because Justin Timberlake was a, you know, main guy. Anyways. Anyways.
And what was the other one? Interstellar, I watched recently.
Oh, I haven't seen it yet.
Personally, I felt like it was overrated.
Okay.
Personally.
Yeah, no, there's a lot of people that are saying that.
Yeah.
So it's like, what, 3 hours?
Yeah, it was 3 hours.
Oh, my God.
I mean, it's an amazing movie, but it wasn't amazingly, like interesting for me.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, the concept was all great.
Wait, what was the movie that Bruce Willis is in?
Which one? Like the old one?
The one about time travel. It's about how he...
Ah, I know that one. I know that one.
These people are time traveling, and then they kill someone, and then they go back
in
time.
Yeah, it's like a butterfly
effect. Yeah.
Oh, I forgot.
Anyways, yeah, that film.
That movie was great, too.
That was a good movie, too.
Yeah.
Time travel. You know what? I'm not a big science buff. I think it's not impossible. Mm. With the way that technology's been going these days, mm-hmm. I don't think it's not impossible. Mm-hmm. Because if you would have told us 20 years ago that I was going to have a phone that I would be texting on, it would be smaller than, you know, about the size of my palm. I would be able to video chat with people around the world. Mm-hmm. I would be able to free call people thanks to things called applications. Mm. I don't think I would have ever thought about this.
Yeah, what's scary is that Bill Gates actually said everything in 1995.
Like, oh, yeah.
He already predicted everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
A lot of people, when Minority Report came out, a lot of people said that the technology that was in Minority Report was already here,
but
they were just not putting it out to the open public, which is now the iReaders. Yeah. They're doing this already in Japan. In Minority Report, where they pass by a machine and then it reads their eye and then it's like, oh, hello, Mr., whatever.
Oh, yeah.
They're doing this with ID checks in Japan, apparently, with a lot of the vending machines for either cigarettes or stuff like that to check age.
That's crazy.
So there's this technology is already here. It's just that they're not releasing it to the public. Even Bluetooth was pretty non-existent back when Minority Report first came out, but everybody uses Bluetooth now.
Right.
So it's, you know, technology is there. And I feel that a lot of the movies that we're seeing, I feel that nothing is impossible.
Yeah.
So is there scientific proof that there is time travel? I'm going to have to say probably not. I know this might be bothering you right now. I think it is possible, though. You never know. There might be people who are time traveling right this moment, and I might be seeing my future self coming back today and seeing this show.
Oh, man, I want to go back and just tell myself, you know,
don't do that.
Yeah, don't do, you know, a bunch of stuff that you already did.
I don't think I would like to interfere, but I would like to go back in history just to, like, you know, just some historical events.
Right? That'd be great.
Like the Prohibition. That'd be really cool.
Prohibition.
No, because, like, you know, a lot of the, you know, even moonshine and all those other, you know, epic things, you know, a lot of things that happened big, that had big ripple effects.
Yeah.
The first female to vote, you know, like that first vote, that would be really cool to see. Mm. You know, some presidents that were...
Oh, I want to go to the 1960s and I want to live in the States and be like a hippie.
Yeah, you know, that'd be great. Like,
you know,
that'd be great.
Yeah, that'd be so awesome.
That would be great. Yeah. I would love to just, you know, go back in time, just see how it was.
Yeah, right.
Just kind of get the essence of it. I feel that, Ashley, nothing is impossible. And I think that this, however cliche it may be, nothing is impossible is, I feel, what is helping everybody do what we're doing now. If people kept saying that phones were never going to be this way, I feel that we'd never get phones like this. You know, the technology. Hey, even my show's going out to places all around the world thanks to the internet.
That's crazy.
It's crazy. I would have never thought that this could happen.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm not sure. I don't know if it's possible or impossible, but I want it to be possible.
Yeah, I want it to be possible too.
I just got, you know, hope. Just got hope it's possible.
I hope so. Going back to our first story, it seems that Team A won. Team A won.
Yay.
And you know what? I'm going to actually give it to Tang today. Tang was talking about as our winner. Because Tang is saying, like, wait, is this story about me? His little sister he was talking about the second story with the whole sister thing and about having to want to punch the boyfriend. But going back to the story, he said he actually had a few incidents with that. So, Tang, we're going to give it to you. Name, number, and address, and Sian's going to be sending you his picture.
My picture.
Yay. You can give it to your sister. Maybe that will get her to break up with her boyfriend. anyways, we're going to close our show for today. No! With Akdong Musicians, Time and Falling Leaves. You can stay in the studio and then just host the show with James.
Oh, yeah. I'm just going to invite him. I mean, I'm just going to interview him.
Yeah, interview him with the show.
Yeah.
We're going to see you next week,
see you guys.
I'll see my listeners tomorrow. Bye!
See you guys with James.